say. Oh, that's all about. Well, this food never sticks to this knife. Hey guys, what is going on location out here in Prishtina, Kosovo, and today we're gonna see what there is to see in this capital city. Now in Skanderbeg Square, if you remember this guy from Albania, we were also in Skanderbeg Square out in Tirana. Along the corner of the Skanderbeg Square, we have the National Historical Museum with what I would consider to be a pretty awesome mosaic. Just like I am a travel lord, Skanderbeg was a feudal lord and military commander from Albania. A lot of the, well, 90% of the residents of Kosovo consider themselves Albanian. You see the Albanian flag and the double-headed eagle everywhere here. And if you forgot, Skanderbeg united the people of, well, I guess Albania, and fought off the Ottomans, which is interesting because right in the background here, we've got a mosque, which is obviously Ottoman influence. Not sure what's going on, but there are a lot of camera lords walking around. Might have something to do with this enormous ball of yarn. I'm not sure. This is Mother Teresa Boulevard, pedestrian walking street. Got a lot of camera lords out. And if you are missing your phone out here, I bet that guy's got it. Bunch of dogs on Mother Teresa Boulevard. This dog is exhausted. And there's some more hanging out in the shade. Hey, grinding the garbage right into this truck. Oh. Huh?
Bomber some tips.
Do you speak English?
No.
Oh, no camera? No. Oh, okay. No? Okay.
Problem.
They didn't want me taking pictures of their special garbage truck. On February 17th, 2008, Kosovo declared independence from Serbia and became Europe's newest country, but it's a bit disputed. Obviously, Serbia doesn't think so. Other countries like China and Russia also disagree, but because it is the newest country in Europe, this is the newborn monument that was put up on the day of the independence. What? So it doesn't say newborn. Is there another one? Well, apparently they changed the lettering this year. But in the past, this has said newborn to represent that it's the newest country in Europe. The bus is in the way. Now it says no new BR, meaning broken republic. So it's not a prank that was actually done on purpose. I came here knowing this was here, but being here, it's pretty wild, man. This is statue of Bill Clinton, American flag blowing in the background. Oh man, huge tribute to Bill Clinton here. If you're not familiar with the history, Bill Clinton played a huge part in the independence of Kosovo. We're right in the middle of Belgrade. Got some beautiful government buildings. And then on just the very next block, you see these ruins. So this was once the Yugoslavia Army headquarters that was bombed by NATO in 1999. And the ruins have never actually been fixed or demolished or taken down. So even though they're right in the middle of the city, they kind of serve as a reminder. It's almost 25 years ago, but the Serbians do not easily forget what happened in 1999 when NATO took the initiative to bomb a lot of their city. Fortunately, this big advertisement, looks like a military advertisement, it's blocking the front end of the building. That's coming apart as well. But yeah, it's kind of surprising to see this on a busy street here. Pedestrians, buses, trams. I mean, that looks like it could just kind of come apart. Just fall on somebody at almost any time. That is pretty crazy. So behind the Bill Clinton tribute here is the Kurrizi Complex, the largest housing project and shopping complex in the city of Prishtina. So let's go ahead and wander around and see what that's like. This whole complex was designed back in the Yugoslavia days. It's pretty cool, they made it so cars can just drive right under all the housing and shopping. Barbershop. You can get a PlayStation 2, some DVDs over here at the CD shop, Mega. Got some English graffiti. One says, "I love your eyes." Thank you. Are we humans? Or are we dancers? Not exactly where I thought that was going. I'm not a dancer, but I am a human. What about you guys? Let me know in the comments. The vibe gets a lot better over here. Got a lot of outdoor bars and cafes. And a nice day like today. Looks pretty awesome. So I cut through some back streets, almost missed it. But here is a restaurant, Liburnia, that was recommended to me by a local. So hopefully they have some good local food I can check out and give you guys the scoop. Pretty impressed with the mise-en-scene of the restaurant here. Like it's got some TripAdvisor awards, certificate of excellence. Even the menu. All right, so what we got here, this is called Elbasan. It's lamb, it's a casserole, they said yogurt and eggs and lamb. Comes with some bread. And I got a Kosovo wine, which is pretty good. Go ahead and give it a try. It looks really good. And the lamb comes apart really easily. Pretty good. I've been looking all day for this. If you search on Google for the Prishtina Old Market or Prishtina Bazaar, doesn't come up, the location doesn't come up. You need to type in Tregu I Vjeter, think, something like that. That's how I finally found it. Tuesday is the market day. Today's Tuesday. Dang, they are all about their cigarettes out here. Look at this wall. Cigarettes next to another cigarette stall. Never sticks to this knife. Oh, now we're in the produce section. Oh jeez, this place is going to blow to the moon. So this used to be a bazaar that was 300 shops, but it got redeveloped, so it's much smaller than it used to be. Bunch of random stuff. Let's go through and find some clothes. Ton of shoes. Oh. Where is this from?
This is Deutsch band.
Huh?
Deutsch.
Yeah, English.
50 centi, this is 1 euro. This is 1921. This is alt.
Oh.
Antique.
Antique, yeah, yeah.
This here. So.
From where? Albania?
No.
No?
Where?
Oh, Nazis.
Hitler.
Oh, from the Nazis. Oh, wow. It's got old cords all over. This guy's just playing chess. Saw this sign up top of these steps and I translated it in Albanian, which is the language here. It says freedom has a name. It is right in front of a very polarizing building. Not really polarizing because of any kind of political reasons, but this is the National Library. And people can't decide if it is beautiful or ugly. So we're gonna take a look. Well, this side's a bit run down anyway, but kind of interesting design. It's a door that isn't the front door, apparently. Let's go find it. I don't know, kind of wondering if this library is still in use. Oh yeah, there we go. Right away we got an American quarter. I think it's just a bunch of stuff about the US. Here's some books. They're not in the best shape. Maybe this is why they have so many vendors out there selling books. There's no books in the library. Got these old conveyor belts, like a return system. For some of these, it looks like somebody really needed to turn the page, see what's on the next page. A cliffhanger. Oh. Ooh. Pretty cool. Here it is from the parking lot. Not much happening on the inside, but a lot happening on the outside. So what do you think of this architecture? Here in the center of town, we have Church of Christ the Saviour, which is a Serbian Orthodox church that is not finished. It was started in 1992 and was seen by the locals as a symbol of kind of Serbian dominance. And as most of the people here are ethnically Albanian, didn't go over well. We're gonna go take a look at it. Originally, this was supposed to have 1,389 crosses to represent the Battle of Kosovo, which happened in 1389, where the Serbian forces fought the Ottomans. And both sides suffered heavy losses. It eventually led to the Serbian forces being so depleted that years later, the Ottomans just came in and took over everything. As you'd expect. Can't get in. I'm gonna lift this up. Apparently not much to see inside. It is quite a massive building right in the middle here. Just to be abandoned, not available to the public. If you take Mother Teresa Boulevard all the way down, you will end up at the Cathedral of St. Mother Teresa. See if we can get up there, get a view of the city. So this is where we were. There's the library. It's even weirder from up here. And then the abandoned Serbian Orthodox Church. This whole street is blocked off. I'm not sure if that's normal. And then the pedestrian walking street starts right there. It's like part of the church is still under construction. So Prishtina is an extremely walkable city. Granted, I'm not going way out to the outskirts, but it seems like everything's a couple minutes walk. Here we have a view from the outside. Yeah, that's where we were. You know, interestingly enough, if you look out in the distance, I didn't point this out when I was up there, but you may see a Burger King and think, who cares? But Kosovo and Albania are two of the only countries in Europe that don't have McDonald's at all. Reminds me of when I was in Bolivia. Bolivia also doesn't have McDonald's. I was hanging out with my buddy Carlos, and he was asking me to describe what McDonald's is like. Just like, I've always wanted to try it. What does it taste like? I don't know, McDonald's. Pretty hard to describe McDonald's to someone who's never had McDonald's. Back on Mother Teresa Boulevard, there are still camera lords everywhere. Everybody doing interviews. Well, that's it. Calling it a day from Kosovo. hope you guys enjoyed the city tour. Saw some weird stuff. See you guys in the next one.